Right there, boys and girls. So Big Red here today. We got a little special surprise for y'all. This is like a treasure, because they don't have many more of these in America anymore. They're like the dinosaur. They're dying out. We're gonna mess up some ponchos. Mexican buffet. And this is like a fat person's greatest buffet, because you only go through the line once. And then if you want some extra food, you raise a flag and the little waitress comes running over to you and hooks you up. You know what I'm saying? So there'll be a lot of flag raising going on. That's all I got to say. You know, and you know, because we are coming to this Mexican restaurant, it's been a few days, I had to work out to get in good shape for this. You know, I mean, you say, fat man, you're fat. What do you mean get in good shape? But look, check it out. I got my six-pack abs on. Look at that six-pack abs right there, huh? Move the bird nest out the way. It says six-pack abs. And look, I worked out and I got them, baby. Six-pack abs for you. Get you some of that. You heard me? All right, so I'm going to pause this up, show you this intro. And we might even video going down the line, watch the little Mexican people serve us some Mexican food. All right. Okay, like I promised, boys and girls, look, there's ponchos. If you are lucky enough to still have one in your area, I remember eating at ponchos when I was a teenager and a kid. But like I said, they're a dying breed. So if you got one near you, go mess them up. Support them so they stay around. All right, so we got our little trays here, and we just mixed your Mexican soft drinks over there. And we're about to get some of this stuff here. And you got your Mexican Jesus gift back there. So look at all that goodness. Yeah, let me get one of them crunchy things, one of those crunchy things, and one of the pepper things.
One chicken?
Let me get one of these crunchy things.
The middle place has incredible.
And some beans and rice. Got some chicken holy moly. Look at all of that stuff there.
And the tamales
chili
relleno.
Rice and beans. Just one and
Do you like cheese? Just on the pepper. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I'd like to get one of each of the enchiladas, please. Okay, thank you. Yes, ma'am. I'd like soft tacos.
How many?
Two. You can put it on the same plate. It's fine. We'll work it out. We'll work it out.
Thank you. Would you like
tea? One chicken, one beef. Yes, ma'am.
Lettuce and cheese.
Lettuce and cheese,
yes, ma'am.
All right, so that concludes our trip down the buffet line there. All right, so we got... we don't have too good of camera placement in here, but... Let's see. Let's try to see if we can get that to... All right, so you don't get to see the food, but... Let me show you the food right quick here, because there's a ton of it. All right, so that's what the big man's gonna eat right there. That's just round one. Round one, before we pull up the flag of surrender and whatnot. So let's see what we can do here. See if it's as good as I remember as being a kid. All right, let's hit this old chili relleno here. AKA the pepper thing. I got my road dog with me, my little man. He's chowing down. Half the plate gone already. But then again, he ain't got as much as the Big Papa. He's an amateur. His first time at Poncho's. Never been to a Poncho's, so. I had to show him in the ways. It's a damn shame. I think there's only two Ponchos that I know of left in the Houston area. One in Houston proper and one in Humble. That's where we at. We in Humble. Or as I like to call it, Humble. Because it's spelled like Humble. There's an H there, but everybody here pronounces it Humble. I'm like, God damn it, you retarded Texans. There's an H there. It's Humble. That's what happens when you live in Texas too damn long. Get sun to the brain. They do have something that I never had at Poncho's before. They got a chimichanga. A little mini chimichanga. See how that is. Never had one at Poncho's before. This is my normal stuff. I got a chili relleno, a taquito, and a flauta, which I call crunchy things, because I don't know which ones are which.
That's the key, that's not.
Beans and rice, and two soft tacos. We all sell the order. For non-authentic Mexican food, it's pretty good. Well, I mean, it might be authentic because I got a bunch of Mexicans working in here, so you never know.
I should come back in here wearing a Deadpool suit. Just order a lot of chimichangas.
And they ain't got no lemons in here. You gotta use, I guess Mexicans put lime in their tea, so. When in Rome, right?
Stop being Ron Burgundy. Stop being Ron Burgundy.
Son, I hate to tell you, that movie didn't start that phrase.
I know.
Calm your nerves.
But still.
Wipe your face.
No.
Because you got sauce. You got holy mole sauce all over you, whatever the hell that is. The hell you got there, son? What did you get?
Two beef enchiladas. One tamale.
How's that tamale? I never had a tamale here.
haven't had eaten it yet.
The tamale ain't on your plate.
That is.
Oh, that's your tamale?
Tamale.
Oh, that looked like one of them crunchy things.
No, it's not. Dude, that's what's inside of a tamale. You know that, right?
I know, inside the corn husk. I know that. But I thought you got two crunchy things like I did.
No.
So today I'm going to try something, since I'm reviewing the joint. I'm going to get a bunch of stuff that I haven't had before. Let you know. So far, one of my favorite things is that Chili Relleno. Love the Chili Relleno. It's got to put cheese on it. Never had their chimichanga before either, but... You didn't get no cheese on your pepper thing? How is it so far? What do you think? For Americanized Mexican. Funny story about the Ponchos where I used to live in St. Bernard Parish, Louisiana. The Ponchos went out of business, I guess because St. Bernard overall had a bunch of fat asses, ate too much food, put them out of business. It became a funeral home. So if you wanted Ponchos in New Orleans, you had to drive out to Metairie. That was the only other Ponchos in New Orleans, was in Metairie. Sometimes when I go to lunch, I take an hour lunch and go to Ponchos about once a month. Get my spick on. So that chimichanga, pretty doughy. Hmm?
Stuff on YouTube, you'll get flagged so quick.
Son, knock it off, okay? I don't need comments. That's why they got the section. You want to make a comment? Leave it in the section. That includes you too.
I'm just telling you.
So the chimichanga, not like any chimichanga I've ever had. Real doughy. Very little filling. And I don't know what it should be filled with.
Not a fan of tamales.
Most chimichangas are filled with beef or something, or chicken.
Or pork.
Or pork. This is almost like a bean.
Tamales.
Huh? Yeah, this chimichanga, it's almost like a bean burrito fried. Don't get me wrong, it's good. A little bird nest doing its job. It's almost like a bean burrito fried. I wouldn't call this a chimichanga. By no stretch. And my son's reporting over there that he's not a fan of the tamale. I'll give it a try. Best tamale you get on the side of the road.
The rest of mine?
No.
However, the enchiladas were awesome.
Which enchilada did you get?
Beef.
You ought to try the Tex-Mex one. Good. Rice is kind of cold, room temperature. Rice is cool, or I should say room temperature, and bland. Not a lot of kick to it for Spanish or Mexican rice. try these beans here. Beans are a little above room temperature. Try the chips and salsa, because I normally never eat the chips and salsa. I usually just use a little salsa on my taco. I put food on it. Get you something else that you like. So my son's over there making faces that he don't like the chili relleno. Told him to put cheese on it, he didn't listen. Cheese burrito, cheese enchilada here. Look good. Slightly above room temperature though. I'm not impressed today. Usually the food's piping hot.
I'm not really impressed at all.
Well, I wanted to take you to some place that you at least liked a little bit, but you didn't want to go there, so this is what you get.
I didn't like really any of the places.
So that plate's done.
I never like really Golden. I really like Golden. I don't remember the other place you made.
The Mossies. Chicken enchilada here. Yeah, it's been better. Everything's room temperature, not hot. And as she walks away, because she really didn't care. You know, it's almost like, how is everything? Yeah, I gotta walk off. Yeah, great service.
Quieter.
And don't bother me. So my son bitching and complaining about either the cold table for the dessert and salad bar or the ice cream machine's too loud. That's his big complaint. Besides, he's pissing him on and he didn't like the food. Offered him three other places to go to. He didn't want to go. So, the sour cream enchilada, let's give that a go.
I'd rather try something new, try something that I think just tastes good. Not like for like the fifth or sixth. The Mossies would be the second.
So the sour cream enchilada tastes good. Again, room temperature. A little above. You want to get you some more?
I'm going to finish that.
You want one of my tacos?
I got enough to know how to fill me up. I wasn't that hungry. That's why I was kind of on where I wanted to go.
I don't know if this is the beef or the Tex-Mex.
That's the beef.
That is the beef. Like the old Wendy's commercial. Where's the beef? It's right here.
What is this stuff around?
Some kind of bread. It's like probably like a cornmeal batter. Fried.
Well, I like the pepper. I don't like the stuff around it.
and pull the pepper out, and you got it. That's why you need the cheese on top of that stuff to kind of give it another. There you go. And I think the reason that Pancho's has a soft-serve ice cream machine to help ease it coming back out. You know what I'm saying. But then again, this ain't real Mexican food. It's not super spicy, so it won't burn that bad. So, maybe, I don't know why they got the ice cream machine. All right, let's do one of these Tex-Mex. You want a bite of this Tex-Mex? It's good. I never did get the whole mole thing, the mole mole. It's like chicken with like almost like a chocolate sauce or some crazy shit like that with some spices in it. I don't know. I've had some good mole before, but. Something on the phone here. What is that?
Everything all right? You need another recipe?
Yes, please.
So what you like?
Pepsi.
That one's knocked out.
Ready for the sopapillas?
No, not quite yet. In a few minutes.
Okay.
Because I think I'm going to want some more off the. I'm going to eat my tacos first, and then I might get some more off the buffet line.
Okay.
What was the price overall?
Like comparison to another restaurant, like kind of.
I don't understand what you're saying.
What was the price like comparison? Like
I don't know. I forgot what it was. I think it's like $20-something.
Quantity good price.
We ain't rating nothing right now, son. That's after. Calm down. Onions smell a little on the funky side.
Sorry, I'm not used to being on your YouTube channel.
Onions smell a little sour. But we'll find out once we start eating some. I guess they're already on my tacos, so I'm gonna find out.
Onions smell sour.
Huh?
No. This smells strong. Not really. I was expecting some punching over.
A little salsa? A little salsa? Let's knock out this beef one first. Thank you. bean taco. Not bad flavor. A little room temperature-ish. I'm starting to think that they went out of business or are going out of business in places, not because people are eating them out of house and home. The quality is not like it was when I was a kid, for sure. I was like, oh, that's that. Thought it was something that something. They haven't changed their menu in years, except for they got rid of an enchilada I used to like, the spinach. Saturday, right?
Yep.
Wednesday? Oh, that's why. Playoffs, that's why it's football on Saturday. Again, chicken taco? Not bad. Just a little above room temperature. Last time I was at Poncho's was about a month ago. Because it's two doors down from where I went and took defensive driving. And not because I had to take it, because I wanted to take it to lower my insurance. So I saw the Poncho's was right next to it. Came in this joint. Loaded up and crop dusted the whole class of defensive driving. Because all them some bitches were a bunch of speeding and wreck causing criminals in there. And little old me. Well, big fat me, if you want to look at it that way. Just trying to lower his damn insurance. So I crop dusted every last one of them. And it was supposed to be comedy defensive driving. That wasn't nothing funny about it. Old girl put on some half-assed comedian that wasn't so funny. Oh, what's his name? I don't even remember his name, but he's the one that talks real low. He ain't that funny. If I'm not mistaken, he's only a stand-up. I've never seen him in a movie. Jim Gaffigan. That's who it was. Not very funny. So if that's what they call comedy defensive driving, sad. Wipe out the bird's nest. All right, so that's all knocked out. Round one's knocked out. So if I could pass the phone over here to my son, so he could watch me raise the flag. Look, watch this. This is how you get more. Turn it that way. Son, pay attention to what you're doing. If you're not, son.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Exactly. Let your phone go and turn it, face it. Thank you.
The camera's there, though. Right now, yeah, no.
Yeah, but you was pointing with it. See, this is how you get more food at Poncho's. So raise the flag. Raise the camera up, son. There you go. Now give me the damn camera back. Because obviously you're more worried about.
Obviously, I'm in the middle of a multiplayer game that I can't pause, and I'm gonna.
Well, lose. You know what you do at a restaurant? You put your damn phone away unless you're videoing yourself. Don't be like them jackasses you see buried in their phone. Buried in their tablet.
Got nothing else to do.
Tables are meant to eat. Have conversations at.
And I'm done eating, and I'm not having a conversation while you're doing your YouTube stuff.
Well. You could have a conversation with me and I could do the YouTube thing at the same goddamn time. You got such a bad attitude these days.
I don't want to.
Does anybody want a 14-year-old? Yeah. I'll sell him for a barrel of monkeys. Well, maybe two barrels because I like monkeys. So, you know, if he keeps acting up, we're either going to sell him to the Indians or trade him for two barrels of monkeys.
It's not going to make sense.
I'd like to try a little bit, not a whole lot, just a little bit of the chicken mole, and then a little bit of the stew.
Okay, they're just, red or they're green?
How about just about this much? Like
I bring a bowl.
Little bowl,
they're
small
green
bowl.
Green chili stew?
One of each. Okay. One of each, because I've never tried them before. I want to try them.
No, you try. It's
yeah,
okay.
And a little bit of chicken mole. Do y'all have a do y'all serve new attitudes? Because he needs one. Look, all these kids with their phone.
Every kid.
Yeah, every kid. Loco.
You need rice?
A little bit. A little bit.
I like the green cheese stew, a little bit rice.
Okay, you make it the way you like it, and I'll try it. I don't know, some crazy old lady like that. I don't know what her problem is.
Right.
I think she said she was borderline retarded.
Wait, what did she even say?
She tapped you on the shoulder and said, "Don't worry, honey, hang in there. I left a man like that." Like, what does that have to do with anything? Fucking retarded hoe. That woman's lucky I didn't get my Indian heritage coming out called Smackaho, because I'm part of the Smackaho tribe. I mean,
I'm not even laughing at that. I'm just laughing at the whole situation.
Nah, that's what I'm laughing at, the whole situation.
No, I'm not even laughing at necessarily the entire situation.
Yeah, well then you just double stand and talk yourself there, son. You ever get a sopapilla or any of that stuff before? You ever try one of them?
I had one at another restaurant.
That's what I like to call beignets without powdered sugar. All right, that looks beautiful. Mm-hmm. I've never tried that before. You said it's good, huh?
You see, I like it rice and the.
You mix, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. You need more, let me know.
Okay, thank you. So I got a whole chicken leg here instead of like pieces of chicken mole. They leave the bone in it. So let's see how that. I don't know if. I don't think I'd ever pick that up and eat it like a chicken leg. It's mole mole sauce. Not so much. I've had mole before, mole sauce, and it's never been this chocolatey. And you might say, fat man, you're fat, you should like chocolate. I hate chocolate. It's overrated. chocolate's overrated. I do like some chocolate, like Reese's peanut butter cups. And I used to like Snickers only if I was drinking Hawaiian Punch. So yeah, that mole sauce, too chocolatey, not spicy enough. I mean, I know mole sauce is chocolate based, but not this chocolatey. Good Lord. Almost like they melted a Hershey bar on top of a, over some chicken. Not so good. So what we're gonna do here is, she brought us some rice. She says it tastes better with rice. So we're gonna split it up. Half of the rice here, half of the rice there. And we're gonna put one stew on top of one. I'm gonna use the rice for the other one, put the stew on that one there. They got a green stew and a red stew. So we're gonna try it like that. We're gonna mix them up. One on one side, one on the other side. All right, let's see what this lady's talking about. Red stew's not bad. Just had a piece of potato and some sauce and I think that's beef in it. Not quite sure. Ain't bad. That's some good stew. So aside from the mac and cheese, now I think I've tried everything on the menu. No, I didn't try tamale yet. I'm going to try one of them in a minute. The stew's actually pretty good. Ain't bad at all. And considering it's freaking 40 degrees outside, the stew's always good. Stew's not bad, the red one. Don't know what it's called, but let's spin this around and try this here. Green chili stew here. See what it's about. Very, very similar. I should say it's very similar with the ingredients, except for the sauces are different. Mm-hmm. just got chicken in it instead of beef. Potatoes and onions. Bell pepper. You want a bite of the stew?
No.
You already tapped out?
Yeah.
Throw up the flag of distress here because we out of drink. You want some papaya, son?
What is that?
Huh?
What's that? Which one's that?
So papaya. You said you've had them before. The ones that look like beignets.
Oh, without... No. I don't remember names. I just remember about food.
Can we get like 4 soap papayas?
Mm-hmm.
And I would like to get some more. Sweet tea.
Okay.
And,
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's no problem. It's like we'll have like a little editing thing.
I know.
Thing.
See,
it's,
you hang your phone because
I'm making a video. Yeah.
So
sweet tea, yes.
And a 4 soap papayas.
4 soap papayas, and I want to try 1 tamale and 1 Tex-Mex enchilada. So she grabbed the flag and swung it around and spun the whole phone around and everything. But it's all right. We'll leave it in there. Atmospheric. Special effects even. Seems like a nice lady. Thank you.
So 2 tamales with cheese?
No, 1 tamale, no cheese. And 1 Tex-Mex enchilada.
Oh, okay.
We got salad on there if you want salad. While I'm waiting for my my stuff there. I might go get some menudo and give that a try. Just so I could report back on it. I never had it here before, but we're going to try. Mm-hmm. And I ain't talking about the band with, what's his name? Oh, Julio Iglesias. Not Julio Iglesias. What's that dude's name? That little Mexican singer guy? That little... Julio Iglesias is his dad. His son. Enrique Iglesias. I don't know. Y'all look it up. Google that shit, because I don't know who was in Menudo. I know he's some famous pop star, Mexican singer, you know. But he ain't one of them little mariachi guys, so. Anyway, let's pause this up. Alright, so we back here. Since I've been gone, the little lady brought my enchilada and my tamale, so let's try this tamale. My son said he didn't like it. Let's see. Probably the warmest thing I've had, but good lord.
That's a new one.
Huh?
Then that's mine was cold.
But it's plain, it's bland, it's dry, it's nasty.
Like I said, and imagine that cold.
Okay, so let's do the Tex-Mex, because I like that one. That's what it's saved the Tex-Mex in case these two soups ain't no good. Cleanse the palate here with some little sweet tea with lime, because ain't no lemons in the joint. So they got a Rancho bean soup here. Give it a taste, give it a try. It's not bad. A lot of beans. Got jalapenos and onions in it and something else that I can't identify. Not terrible. That unidentifiable thing's a chunk of beef. I guess for flavor. Alright, that wasn't terrible. Probably by far the hottest thing. Now do the menudo. Not the best menudo I have, but it's alright. At least it's hot. You sure you don't want to try the menudo? Alright, that's done. Now we're just waiting on our sopa pillars. Here comes the sopapillas. And can we get some honey? Because I like them sweet like my senoritas. Thank you. Even though no smoking sign here is in Espanol, and no fumar. I think that's what it says in Spanish. I don't know. I think fumar is smoke. I don't know. But that's what it says. No fumar. Not to be confused with fubar. It's always a bad sign when you go to an ethnic, different ethnic or cultural restaurant or eatery, and you don't see that race of people eating there. So you could tell this ain't real Mexican. This is Americanized garbage Mexican. All right. Well, we're done with our meal. We tried everything on the menu. Let's get our sopapillas, aka sopapillas, or as this Cajun boy likes to say, beignets without powdered sugar. Son, you gonna eat one of these while they're still hot?
Nope.
You're not gonna eat a sopapilla?
Nope.
Why not?
Because I'm not hungry.
Huh?
I'm not hungry. I'm full. Hey.
But it's something, it's a dessert. Sweet. You need something sweet.
I don't.
It might change that attitude. Make you sweet, young man. Instead of one of them know-it-all gangsters.
I'm not know-it-all.
You're not a know-it-all gangster? You damn thugs. All right, you gotta bite the corner off, put your honey inside and swirl it around, let it get everywhere. And then you knock it out. Hot bush stuff. I wouldn't have ordered so many if I knew you wasn't going to eat none. I asked you if you wanted some, and you said yeah.
I didn't. I said no.
Okay. We got the replay. We'll play it back. Well, well, if you use real words instead of trying to sound like a billy goat over there, nah, and say yes or no. It's a lesson to all you young kids. Use proper words, yes or no. Clears things up a lot. You don't go in the boardroom and the executives and the CEOs in there and they ask, they say yay or nay. Or yes or no. They don't go, nah. You don't see them. And they Fortune 500 some bitches. How you gonna run a company sounding like a billy goat?
I don't do that when I'm in a professional environment.
Well, this is a professional Mexican buffet.
Exactly.
Well, Mexicans cook the goat. Well, better not yay and nay like that. Ah, probably think your goat cook your ass. But they did have a place here. I forgot the name of it, but they closed now. They had some of the best barbecue goat burritos ever. The place closed down. I think now it's a nightclub. Get one more of these little sopapillas. Thank you. might need one more glass of tea and then we're done. You want anything else before we go?
Nope.
No, I think I could pass on the tea. I'm good. So, let's think about this here. I realize why they're going out of business. Oh, I sent you here. Why not? About half a glass. Sweet tea. Thank you. So, let's think about this. I think they're going out of business because the quality has gone downhill. It's not the punches I remember as a child or a young teen. Service is still about the same. Just the foods. Thank you. Just the food has gone downhill. Taste is about the same. Maybe a little step down than what it used to be. But everything I've had, except for that last Tex-Mex enchilada, was room temperature at best. Well, maybe a little above room temperature, so. With that being said, cooked food, about a 2 flip-flop on a good day, 2. Or at least on today, it's 2. Salad bar, it's terrible. They didn't even get no salad, just looked terrible, so we're going to give that a 1. Dessert bar, looked terrible. Give it about a 1. The sopapillas was swinging. They're always good. AKA beignets without powdered sugar. They are, I'll give that about a 3. It's not enough to save the place. So overall, I'll give it a 1.5, 2 flip-flops. 1.5 or 2 flip-flops overall on a good day. The cleanliness, it's clean. The busboy picked up the tables at a normal rate. Wasn't very professional. He sat in the corner eating some pudding at the waiter's table, or the waiter's refill station. Watched him doing that. I mean, if you're gonna work at a restaurant and eat, do it where the customer can't see you. The waitress, she was good, pretty attentive, except for swinging the phone around, which she didn't know it was at, so you can't really blame her. Very nice, very friendly. Again, not enough to save the joint. Give the service about a 3. So, in closing, like I said, overall, place gets a 2, maybe 2.5 flip-flops at best. So, with that being said, Big Red, signing out. You know, if you like the video, subscribe, click the like button, share it with your ma, your pa, your greasy grandma. Tell your friends, tell your family. Fat man just trying to get paid so I can get to the next buffet. You hear me? Stay safe. Eat, drink, be merry. And see you next time.
So after yesterday's fiasco at Poncho's, I thought about it. And the conclusion I have is, I live in Houston. So, if you want Mexican food, don't go to Poncho's. You're better off going to Taco Bell, and that's crap. There's a taqueria on every freaking corner. You know, but, you know, white trash likes buffets, so steer clear of Poncho's. Not worth it anymore.